seek only to die gloriously in battle, that they may win the favour of Odin and go to the Hall of the Slain in Valhalla, there to sit at a great mead bench, dine forever on the flesh of the great boar Serimnia, and be attended by beautiful maidens. But only for the brave. And so, once again, for the last time, our army surge forward. Who will have the glory of the final victory? Let's have a cheer for the Northumbrians, if you support the Northumbrians. Let's have a cheer for the Vikings and the sons of Ragnar. Both sides fighting furiously, both keeping their lines in good order. Northumbrians have swept around once again, seeking to compress the Vikings, making it harder for them to bring their weapons to bear. But the Viking right flank once again has broken through and is seeking to sweep around the Northumbrian rear. And this is the nature of warfare at this time. This is a pretty accurate description of how a battle of this size and scope would have gone. But the Northumbrians seem to be maintaining their discipline. Their line is stretched but still strong. But what is now their left flank is sorely pressed and somewhat stretched. Now there are no referees on this battlefield. It is down to the individual honour of each warrior to accept that though his blood may be up, so too might be his number. And this is the time in the battle where I wonder what on earth is going on. All we can do is wait for Odin's judgment and let the ravens pick the bones out of it. I think I can see more Northumbrians on their feet. Still a few Vikings bravely fighting on. Northumbrian lords calling their men into form groups so they can better understand what's going on. Don't go into the battle on your own at this stage. Join with your shield companions. Join with your shield brothers and let us attack them together. Still, I can see one of the sons of Ragnar still fighting on. Bjorn Ironside in the midst of his men. Doing his father proud. And this is a brutal combat. Whichever side wins can only call this a Pyrrhic victory. It has been a mighty contest. So many slain and stretched on the ground. Neither side has given this field easily. your nine side, rallying his men, calling them to him. But I fear there may be too few to rally. And Bjorn, it appears, has fallen. Just the last few of his house carls still fighting on. Not fighting now for victory, but fighting for their place at that mean bench. One warrior taken down by three Northumbrians has assured his place at Odin's table, will die with a fierce grin on his lips. And really are not giving up. And Ayla walks among his pitifully few men, crossing himself. This is very much a Pyrrhic victory, but it is a victory for Northumbria. And Ayla stands glorying in his victory.